मॉर्निंग शमस्टार्स, वेलकम टू क्लास। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। इन टूडेज क्लास वी कॉन्टिन्यू विद आर चैप्टर नंबर 2 ऑफ बुक 1, द डेमोग्राफिक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इंडियन सोसाइटी। सो आर टूडेज टॉपिक इज एज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन। द एज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पॉपुलेशन रेफर्स टू द प्रपोर्शन ऑफ पर्सन इन डिफरेंट एज ग्रुप्स रिलेटिव टू द टोटल पॉपुलेशन। एज स्ट्रक्चर in a country changes with the development level of that country. Now there is a word, dependency ratio. It is the measure comparing the portion of population which is composed of dependents with the population, a portion that is working, means generally in the age group of 15 to 64 years. On the other hand, the dependent includes the elderly and the children. There is a formula to find out the dependency ratio. That is, dependency ratio is equal to population of below 15 plus population of above 64 divided by population of 15 to 64 age group. Means divided by the population between 15 to 64 age group. Next is sex composition of population. So we can say that sex composition play an important role in demographical analysis of country. Economic and population growth of a country depends on the sex composition to a large extent. Now if we talk about sex composition, it varies from state to state in India. Like in Kerala, or we can say the Kerala is only state of India in which the female population is more than the male population. There are some reasons for fall in sex ratio. The main reason for the fall in male and female ratio in India are child marriage, relative neglect of girls, lack of nutritious food, lack of care of pregnant women, female foeticides, and generally the poor condition of women. These are some of the reasons for the declining sex ratio in India. Now our next topic is rural-urban differences. Due to industrialization, the process of industrialization, the urban population in India is increasing. According to 1961 census, 82% of India's population lived in the villages, while only 28% of India's population live in cities. After that, according to census 2011, there are 46 metro cities in India where the population is above 10 lakh each. So according to 2011 census report, 68.8% Indians lived in villages and 31.2% live in cities. So rapid growth in population poses various challenges and also provides opportunity. We need to meet all the needs of rapidly growing adolescents and young adult population and to cater to their increasing expectations for improved quality. There is migration process from rural area to urban areas as there are better job opportunities. They get the quality of life. So most of the people are moving from rural area to urban area. Now our next topic is national population policy, or we can say population policy of India. In 1952, India was the first country in the world to launch a national program emphasizing family planning to the extent necessary for reducing birth rate, to stabilize the population at the level with the requirement of national economy. So after 1952, sharp decline was there in death rates. However, no time from 238 million to 1 billion in the same period. India's current annual increases in population of 15.5 million is large enough to neutralize efforts to conserve the resources and environment. Some of the main objective of the population policy, or we can say family planning policy, is first to reduce total fertility rate to 2:1. Second, to provide top quality contraceptives to adopt the standard of 2 children. Third, to aim at full coverage of registration of birth, death, marriages and pregnancies. Fourth, to provide injections to prevent diseases of children. Fifth, to reduce infant mortality rate to 30% per 1,000. Sixth, to reduce the number of dropouts from school by 20%. These are some of the objectives of that population policy or family planning policy. Students, these are some of the questions based on today's lecture. Try to do it in your notebook.
Thank you, Shamstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries on Google Classroom. Take care.